This is part three of my V2 DLG mods and assembly, fitting the spring pull system for elevator and rudder. I showed how to form the exit holes for the pull line in part two, so I won't repeat that here. It's easier to do it before you put the elevator on. Now I'm using the pushrod wire to form the torsion springs. Start with an 11 centimetre long piece, and then I bend two 25mm legs, leaving a 60mm centre section. There are a few different shaped springs you can use. You can use an L-bend, which is like a C-bend but bent in half at the middle, or you can use two C-bends. I'm just using a single C-shaped spring. They seem to work fine for me. With these foam core tails, you can just push the spring into the body, making sure it doesn't poke out through the sides. You can see I'm using my fingers to feel when it's getting too close to the surface. I'm using another piece of wire to form the other hole. You need to make sure these holes are exactly the same length apart as the center section of your spring, otherwise the spring will work its way out slowly. So that's working well, that's the rudder, and now it's time to do the same thing for the elevator. And here I'm adding a drop of CA to the holes, or where the spring enters the foam, just to toughen up that area a little bit. For the pull line, I'm using kevlar kite string. You can use any non-stretch line like Spectra or Dacron, whatever you can find. I tape the line to one of the push rods so that I can thread it down through the fuselage. Otherwise, it's pretty hard to get it down the full length. I bent up some little Z-bend hooks from the push rod wire and I just tie the control line to that, and that hooks into the control horn. You don't have to worry about slop in these connections because they're always under tension. And I'm just following the same procedure for the elevator, threading the control line through. And that's the tail end done. Time to connect up the servo now. So I thread the line through two holes drilled in the servo arm. Here I'm threading it through the inner hole, but later on I changed it to the outer hole so that I could get enough control surface movement. Now you need to center up the servo and pull up the tension on the line and lock it off around a little screw on the other end of the servo arm. And there it is working. I find it easier to set up than a pushrod system. It's lighter weight and more accurate and just better looking.